trying to take our RX-7 for a ride. Since it's nice and warm and it runs in warm weather. Alright, so now the quote fun part. I don't even want to do this. Oh, that is horrible. Oh, that's disgusting. Oh, he's a good puppy. Yeah. Don't you eat none of my tools now, okay? What are you sniffing? I got a puppy. Alright, watch out. Feels like I'm fingering grilled cheese. You wanna feel it?
No.
You wanna finger my grilled cheese?
How do you know what fingering grilled cheese is like?
That's a good question. Alright, so here we have a 2013 brand new Scion FR-S. That's right, it has about 600 miles on it, bought it with 300 miles. And basically, the car doesn't really handle as well as it could. In fact, it handles worse than the Mustang because it has all stock suspension, cheap tires. In fact, the tires are specifically made so they'll slide. And I don't know if you guys can see it, but I had a little incident with the side of the road this morning, and well, I'm just glad that my suspension's here and I can start making this car handle better. But the red FRS is only going to be showing videos that are fully edited and have a very, very, very good structure. So while we're working on the silver car, it's going to be GoPro on my head, and we're gonna do the job, no cuts, no edits, start to finish, how long it takes, what it actually takes to do it. Whereas the red car is gonna be more like every other video, only we're gonna try to make it, you know, entertaining while being informative and quick and to the point. So instead of a 2-hour video, it'll be a 10-minute, 15-minute video. You'll still learn most of the information, but you'll have fun along the way. So for this car, you know, if you don't want to watch a long video, then get the hell off my video and go to the red FRS's videos, which are on the same playlist. But what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna see if I can get this rear sway bar off without actually jacking the car up and down. The video is recording, so that's good. You never know, you know, you never know if it's still recording or not. One of my older GoPros will stop recording sometimes just for no reason. I think the memory card's damaged, but alright, so now, well, now on this side of the car, no, it's still just right there. So I already read through the instructions once. We're gonna pull them up. I got the front and rear mixed up. Rear bar, okay. So it's for the FRS 2013 Plus, rear bar, hardware kit, bushing, information kit, instructions. So we move the front out of the way. Move that out of the way. Uh-oh. I'm assuming the rear bar is the smaller one. They're not labeled, are they? I don't see why it wouldn't be the smaller one, because that's how it was on the other car I did. You know, the lighter weight, the less of a bar you need. Yeah, that's the rear bar. All right, begin by raising the vehicle. Never work under a vehicle that is not supported. So, disclaimer there. Disconnect end links from the OE bar, remove the bolts that secure the bushing brackets to the subframe, then remove the bar from the vehicle. Be careful to note the orientation of the OE bar. So this bar has an orientation. To me, it doesn't look like it. It looks like it's flat. But we will be careful. I believe that this is probably going to be facing up. So there's your part number, in case you really can't figure out which bar is which. But I would assume they had to have this facing up. But we're going to have to just be careful and check. And then apply some lubricant to the inside of the bushings. Then install them on the bar. Install the bar on the vehicle and secure it with the bushings and brackets. And secure the end links to the ends of the bar. Double check to make sure everything is properly positioned. And road testing, double check all hardware. So they don't give you torque specs for this car, which is a little annoying. But basically you get everything tight and then you go drive it and then you tighten everything again. But the Mustang had a popping sound after I installed these bars, and it was very intermittent. And when I talked to Eibach on the phone today, because I was asking him some questions about this, they said popping sounds come from the end links, so check the end links. Squeaking sounds come from the bushings, so check the bushings. So if the Mustang ever starts making that noise again, which it hasn't for the last couple months, then I'll check the end links on it. For this car, we're gonna make sure we get the bushings greased up properly. Hardware kit, 82105.312HK. Okay. So the other thing is you don't want to scratch this bar, because I mean, it's nice and powder coated, and well, hopefully they powder coated it. And so you want to try to protect your nice new finished part. You don't want your instructions blown away. So I don't know if we'll be able to get to the front today, because the front's a lot more work and I don't want to get stuck without a front sway bar, you know. But the exhaust is delayed until the end of March at the earliest, so the exhaust is gonna be pretty awesome anyway. So this, and then we need our wrenches and stuff. So it doesn't even give us wrench sizes in the instructions, which I'm pretty sure the Mustang instructions, I think they did. So I'm a little disappointed by that. But, you know, it's a newer car, so maybe there's rules. I don't know, you know. Car companies seem, Scion's a lot better about it. But a lot of other car companies are pretty greedy about stupid little things like that. Okay, it's not a 13. And I'm getting new tools. I have a new toolbox, but I still need new tools to fill the box. So I have a deep well, so I'm not gonna use an extension, whereas if I didn't have a deep well in my hand, then I'd be using an extension. So we're gonna, okay, so that was barely on there. So I don't know, that was barely tight. So that might be why there's no torque specs, because it was, you know, I mean, the factory obviously uses automatic wrenches, but everything else is probably torqued to the right, you know, setting. Okay, let me get my extension out here so I can spin these off. Those fucking birds are flying right over my head, I swear to God. If I get shit on, I'm gonna fucking, ugh. Alright. This takes me any more than 30 minutes to do, not including all the talking, then I'm gonna be pretty ashamed, because this is a fairly simple, and I could be using a magnet tray, but I don't think I'm gonna have any trouble keeping track of these little parts. Ugh. So that I have to reuse. I'm gonna put it off to the side here with those. And then to actually get to the other link, this might be why they want you to jack up the car. It's kind of not that easy to get to. So I can do it like that. Oh, it's not the same bolt size. That's so dumb. Ugh. So fucking stupid. All right, 13. Try a 13. Why it wouldn't be the same bolt size, I don't know. You know, I mean, yeah, okay, so the stress testing says you need a 13 on the end link. Well, then put a fucking 13 on the bushing bracket. I mean, for fuck's sake. That's not even a 13. Is it a 14? Are they using even numbers on this car? Do I have a 14? Yeah, my tool situation's not good. I'm trying to fix that, but... Oh, man. 13. 12. 14. I should be wearing my mechanic's gloves, but this car is so new. And this job is so easy. Oh, that's probably why they wanted you to remove the end links first, because now that's not wanting to break free. I'm smart. I'm gonna have to hold it. Uh-oh, this thing's on here really good. Like, really, really good. There we go. All right, so for the other one, do the end link. Or for your car, do the end link first, like the instructions say. Don't be like me and ignore them. All right, yeah, these end links look pretty fucking weak. No wonder they sell replacements. But, I mean, if that's a steel bar and it's a good quality steel, I don't see why it would fail. Well, not for street use anyway. Man, that thing's got the shit rusted out of it. I haven't worked on something in so long. I was just filming the install that we're still editing the video for the install for the red car for something else. Not for sway bars. He did something else first, but we're still editing that video. It's gonna take a while because we keep sending revisions back and forth and trying to find a sponsor because making these videos is not cheap. Well, this video obviously is cheap, but the production values of the other one are much higher. Trying to get some better music and better editing and trying to fix the aspect ratio problem by might upgrade my editing software to a newer version because I'm about 2 years out of date now, which doesn't sound like a lot, but it really is. All right, so that's out. So now I can, That's stuck on there. Come on, off. Come on, off. That might be a problem. Deal with that later. Blah. Alright. We'll do the link piece first. And then we'll do... Oh, I didn't think that through. All right. Man, I can barely see that. I don't know if you guys can see that at all. Trying not to smack my... Man, it would be a bitch to change these lower control arms. I really hope I don't... Apparently, the Eibach kit... Well, the lowering springs I have create a really high camber. Camber on the rear wheels. And some people like to fix that. But for racing, it's actually not that bad. But if I wanted to fix it, I'd need new lower control arms, which is extremely expensive and by no means an easy install, no matter what people try to tell you. So, we got that, put that somewhere where we won't lose it, and then we want this, and the exhaust is in the way this time, so this might be a little more, shit, exhaust is right in the fucking way. Smart. So I need a 12 millimeter. Okay. Try that. Nope. Did I just pull that out of 1/2, 13, 12. Alright. That is a lot of fucking birds. I'm just gonna sit under the car here and try not to get under them. Alright. Man, it almost seems like it's American. It just doesn't fit. Either that or my sockets are all hogged out from being abused so much. Couldn't imagine a hardened steel socket would wear out so quickly. Although I guess it has been at least 6 years. Might be time for some new ones. These fucking birds are so loud. Now on the Mustang, there was tons of new hardware, not just bushings. Like, it obviously, I don't think it had a sway, no, it didn't have a sway bar on the rear, so that's why there was so much hardware on the rear. But I think even on the front, there was a lot more hardware than what this kit provides. I don't know, I guess they trust Toyota more than they trust Ford. Oh, those birds are annoying the fuck out of me. Alright, that came off fairly easy. Now this one, oh, that one came right off. Well, fuck, now the question is, how do I get it off the car? The exhaust is in the way. Shit. There we go. Alright, you see that? So I went in and turned and out. Now that's the way the new one's gotta go in. Hopefully without scratching the crap out of it. Okay, so I don't understand what they mean by note orientation, because they're the exact same and there's no like this. So I don't know. But the part number's upside down. Interesting. Alright, so the new bar, which is substantially thicker, of course it's supposed to be tubular. Yeah. I don't know if this is. This might not be. Maybe it is, but that's a huge fucking difference. And they said to use the outer setting, the softest setting, to try it, and then switch to the harder if it's not enough. Because I asked him, I was like, the soft setting says wet, and the dry setting says dry road, or blah. Soft setting says wet roads, dry setting says dry roads. And I was like, am I supposed to change it every time it rains? And he's like, no, that's just a guideline generally. You start with soft and you work your way up. Where the Mustang, I just set them in the middle because there were three of them. So it was a lot easier to, you know, to do that. So the new bar, these bushings are on the outside of this. So that's probably the only orientation that they really care about. And it looks like the bushings are symmetrical in a way. What the fuck? That doesn't look right. All right, so this time I'm going to jack up the car correctly. The oil change video I read, I was reading the owner's manual, and there's a specific point, place, they want you to jack up the car, and it is using the diff, which is fucking stupid. I've never actually seen anything at all that would actually tell you to use the differential for a jack. And it makes no sense to me. It's extremely concerning. But that's right, that's exactly where the owner's manual wants you to do it. And I don't even see where the jack would go. Because if you were to, say, put the jack here, it would break the seal on the diff. But if you put it back here, it would fuck up this fill plug. I don't know, I don't like that. I'd rather use this. This big old thing. Maybe this is what it meant, is it wants you to use this. I don't know. Oh, wow, they smashed the exhaust to fit. Look at that. I don't know if you guys can see that. They smashed the exhaust to fit under this. Wow. Wow, that's lazy. Oh, I'm glad I'm getting a new exhaust. Anyway, I feel like this would be a strong enough steel to lift the car. Why would I want you to use the diff? That makes no sense. That makes no sense. This seems strong enough. I mean, it's holding. Yeah, I'm gonna use this right here. This might make it kind of difficult to get the sway bar. Well, I really don't even need to jack the rear end up to do this, because I've already gotten it out once. It's just a pain in the butt. Yeah. Okay. No crunching noises, so I think we're good. I wish this was a light and not just a reflector. That'd be pretty cool. Wonder if there's upgrade kits for that. I really don't even need to get the wheels off the ground. I just need to give myself some room to work. Well, I gotta have enough room to get a jack stand under there. So I'm gonna have to come off the ground some more. Close. Okay. Put the jack stand. Right there. And we only really need one of them because, well, nah. Just do it safe. Be safe about it. Alright. So, okay, now we can go and get our tools. Alright, so, lesson learned, always check your parts before you start an install. But anyway, got the parts we need now. So we got our new bushings, and we've got grease and instructions and a towel. So basically, disconnect link, erase vehicle disconnect links, remove bolts. Apply some polylubricant to the inside of the supplied Eibach rear bushings and install them onto the Eibach bar. Install the Eibach bar onto the vehicle and secure with the OE bushing brackets and OE hardware. secure the OE end links to the ends of the Eibach bar using the OE hardware, double check to make sure everything is properly positioned and tightened, road test and tighten again. So right now the car oversteers, so we're going to put it on the softest setting and see what happens. I have spun the car out twice from oversteer. Of course, I was also trying to drift, but anyway, we're going to... Ooh, that warmed up. Going to have the part number facing up, even though there is no left or right side that I can see. There really isn't, so... Anyway, we are going to lubricate our bushings here. They are split bushings, so you can get them on. I don't know how I'm gonna do that, honestly. It's gonna be messy. There is no side to them. I'll have the part numbers facing out. Alright. If you don't lubricate this right, it's gonna make noise, and then you're gonna be pissed. So, put a bunch of this in here. Basically, we'll use half of it. It probably seems like a lot, but it's better than not enough. Alright, so half of it goes into that one. And half... God, those birds are annoying. Half goes into this one. There's way more than that one. God, those birds just don't go away. I'll tighten these head straps eventually. Alright, so now the quote fun part. I don't even want to do this. Oh, that is horrible. Oh, it's like... Oh, that's disgusting. Oh, man. I don't even want to say it, but I am so glad that is not what you-know-what feels like. Because that would just be repulsive. Oh, that is... Oh, that's nasty. Oh. Oh, that is nasty. All right. Now we actually have to get it on the bar somehow. I have a feeling this is going to be a pain. Try to hold the bar up. Or not. That was actually pretty easy. Okay. Okay. All right, so kind of work it, make sure it's nice and smooth, and it is. That's good. Nice and smooth. Man, it went from freezing cold to sweating hot. This is gonna be a rough summer. Alright, so now we have to get it in the car somehow. There we go. Okay. Alright. to get that one in. And then, that one. There we go. All right, now the softest setting is the outside. And I know that just from basic math and torque and leverage. But I will double check. Okay, yep, that's right. So, softest setting, which is still firmer than factory, of course. Reduce our oversteer. And want to just throw off the other one. Okay, just try to play a little balancing game. Now we can get our bracket and hook it back up there. Okay. And get the bolts back in for the bracket. Ah! Shit. This might be a problem. I'm gonna do the top bolt first. Jacking up the car made it a lot easier. It's not necessary, but it definitely made it easier. Oh no. This thing's not gonna behave now, is it? Alright. That's gonna be a pain in the ass. Come on. It doesn't want to go in. Shit. Well, what the fuck? Let's put the bracket on for the other one. Ah. Ah. Screw in or bolt in first. Cannot wait to get rid of this giant muffler. Especially because it says Subaru on it. God, Subaru's on half this car. I mean, I understand that, but at the same time, I don't like Subaru. Alright. Yeah, these just don't want to go on. I don't know what the deal with that is. It's a little concerning. Spin that on there so it doesn't pop back off. Okay. Now we can tighten that down. Well, no, we should. We should get this one on first. Somehow. Okay, just a little muscle. All right, now we can go ahead and tighten them down. Let's tighten this first, of course. Snug it and then do this one. Shit, something's going on with this one. It's not threading in. Fuck. Ah, what the hell? Just don't have a good angle on it. Fucking hell. Take this one out. I can figure out what the hell is wrong with the top one. I can't tell if it's even in the threads. Feels like it is. Fuck. Get it out of there. All right, we're gonna hook that there. We're gonna try to feed this in, get it started. There we go. That's got it. I don't know what the deal with that was. Time we'll snug the top one first. Well, we'll do them more evenly. How about that? Let's try that. Snug that, come over here and Look at that. All right, now we can tighten it. Just gotta make sure we come back and check it after we drive. All right, now we can do. Okay. Alright, that side's done, and that took way too long to do. Oh. I need to rent a power washer and clean off this driveway. Boy, got lots of work to do on this house. But, car's more fun to work on. Houses are a pain in the ass to work on. Well, I can use an extension on this side because the exhaust isn't in the way. Snug it. Snug it. And then tighten. Okay. Tighten. All right, now we can head on to the front. Gotta get the jack stands out. Get the jack out. Oh shit, the car actually fell down onto the jack. And that is why jack stands are there, because this car sagged. If I had been under that, without jack stands, it probably would have crushed me. Some more. Get this fucker as far off the ground as we can, because you have to remove the skid plate, which is going to be a pain in the butt. That's a problem. The jack's not rolling forward. There it goes. Okay. Alright, now jack stands. And we're gonna put them. Well, I don't know where to put it. Just put it there. Try that. All right, so to get to the sway bar, you have to remove one of these skid plates, I think. All right, so you have to remove the aluminum and the plastic skid plate. It's a 10 millimeter socket, and I'm gonna use my magnetic parts tray because there are a lot of bolts to remove. This is gonna be a pain in the ass. I'm gonna have to pay special attention to see if they're different sizes, because then it's really gonna be a problematic. This one's loose already. And the reason why I'm using the small ratchet is so I don't accidentally, you know, fuck up this cheap material. I'm gonna have to go on the other side. But first, ooh, that's odd. It's a different size. I think that's part of the subframe bracket. I don't know, that's weird. I'm gonna do the small size first, I guess. I guess I could remove it all as one piece. But that might. Yeah, let's try that. Let's try to pull it all out as one piece. Ooh. Okay. Don't want to break it. Tighter these, this one. That's a little tighter. Okay, so now I need to get, I'm assuming that's gonna be a 12, which I already have, and a bigger ratchet size right here. Oh, that was loose. That was really loose. It's kind of scary. That was loose too. Okay, now to go to the other side and finish up. Ah. Okay, so, just got sand in my ear. All right, I'm gonna keep pulling out these small ones. Thing's not falling down yet, so concerned might be something hidden up Oh, there we go. Something right here. Now it's gonna fall. No, oh, it wants to fall. We gotta get rid of these two. Big ones. Okay, so now this, looks like there's some bolts on the front. Leave that back there because we don't really need it for anything else. This fucking skid plate's a pain in the ass. Where'd that just go? Shit. Where'd it go? Oh man. Just disappeared. This thing's still not coming down? You gotta be kidding me. Oh, what? How the heck am I supposed to remove all that? What is the... Those little pop tabs aren't meant to be removed. Like, I'm pretty sure if I remove them, it's gonna break them and I'm gonna have to go buy new ones. What the fuck? Unbelievable. You've gotta be kidding me. Flathead screwdriver? So, we were gonna try to get these pop tabs out, and my friend that actually called was asking me about the transmission oil, and he made a good point that you could change the transmission oil these aren't gonna come off without breaking. That's BS. Whoever designed that is a jackass. Yeah, those are definitely not meant to help. Oh, that sucks. I still don't know where this bolt went. We're gonna have to pop all of these out. Hopefully without screwing up the pan. Yeah. That's gonna be a problem. These are supposed to just pop back out. Like they're supposed to release. Like that one. This one just released on its own. Even though it's still stuck. I'm gonna have to get all new ones. Oh, fuck. That sucks. Using these little plastic things was a BS move. Ugh. Oh, man. This sucks. Come on. Yeah, I might as well change my transmission oil while I'm under here, because damn. Well, I think that might... Well... Of course, the manual says you don't ever have to change the manual transmission oil, so... I don't know. People are playing that music too loud. They're gonna get my video copyright strike. That pissed me off. Alright. Whole thing's gonna fall on my face. Oh shit. That's not good. Oh crap. That's a problem. Out of my car. Ugh. Alright, I want to try to avoid scratching this up. I'm gonna have to take a break from this video. So we got the skid plate off and out of the way, and we are now, and Brad's not too happy about not being able to park in the driveway right now, or in his spot. But that says Subaru too. Subaru, made in Japan. Undercover FTM. TM trademark, or is that a part number? Anyway, be careful with this. You don't want to like step on it and break it, and there goes $100 or whatever. But those little plastic pieces, I put those off to the side so I can go to the dealership and get new ones. I'm sure the cover will hold on without them for the time being, because they were only on the aluminum cover holding the fender panels in place. So our next step is to get the old bar out, and to do that you have to take down some braces. I don't know what size they are. We'll start with our 12 and see how close we get. So it looks like we have to take this down, which, is that piece of plastic attached to it? You gotta be kidding me. Why do they always have to make it so difficult? Unbelievable. Oh, it's like they enjoy screwing with you. Yeah, I think that piece of plastic's gonna have to come down. I'll try without taking it down. Okay, it's not a 12. It's our 14. See, this might need a torque wrench to go back together, which they don't have any torque specs in the instructions. But that is on there tight. It's even got, looks like Loctite. I'm gonna have to make sure I put some Loctite on it when it goes back in. Oh, yeah, it's definitely got some kind of thread locker on it. Eibach instructions don't say anything about that either. Alright, so there's two different sizes, so we need to be careful of that. And then, there's two of them up here too. I probably should undo this first. That looks like a 17. If I can find a 17. I don't know if I'll be able to even get the socket on it because it's not a deep well socket. No, I need a deep well socket. Ah! Bumped my head. Well, not my head, the camera. Alright. I'm in trouble if I don't have a 17 deep well. Find something similar in American. 9/16, not even close. 15. Man. 3/4. Nope. 5/8. Too small. I'm in troubles. Here's a 17 with a larger ratchet. Now I'm gonna have to be careful with this because this is gonna have a lot of extra torque. Might be what I have to use to retighten those, because those were pretty tight. But anyway, we wanna, man, there's not even, it's not really much room to work with. Joint just spinning in its socket? Uh-oh. That might be a problem. The ball joint's just spinning in its socket. How the hell am I supposed to get that off? Oh man, you gotta be joking. I don't know how to do that. There's no like place for a wrench. I don't think that's supposed to spin in that socket like that. Pain in the butt. Ugh. Ugh. Where'd the fucking socket go? Okay, hopefully these two are the same size. Or same length, I should say. What? I can't even get my right hand in there. What the f- oh, I'm gonna have to use this. It's a 14. Oh. Oh. Does this not have an extension? Thought I had an extension for this thing. Oh, man. That's trouble. Yeah. Okay, gotta be careful that these might be different lengths. Okay, they're the same. Good. They definitely have... Yep, that piece of plastic is mounted on it. Oh, what a pain. What an unnecessary pain. Ah! Man, I'm gonna have to buy a ton of these fucking tabs. That one I might be able to save. Yeah, that one's savable. Good. Good, good, good. I'll put it right there. Okay, so now this is basically free except for that problem. I don't know how I'm gonna solve that problem. Ugh. This is definitely not the right way to do it. I'm gonna tear up the boot on it. Sake, come off of there. Unbelievable. Can't even tell if it's... Alright, take these tools over to the other side. Whoops, I took that with me. Okay. Now I should be able to work with my right hand, and it should go a lot quicker this time. So, first thing we want to do is break this free. Oh, there's literally no room to actually get a wrench on it. Now see, that one's not. That one's a little bit better behaved. A lot better behaved. Socket on it. Oh, come on. This has Loctite on it too. That's got a ton of Loctite on it. Oh, man, that's gonna suck. Alright, so now I gotta try to pop this without breaking it. Break it. Okay. I think it's reusable. All right. Now, these are definitely torqued and Loctited, so I'm gonna have to Loctite them and then come back with a torque wrench after I find out what the heck they're supposed to be torqued to. Well, that would make sense because then the Loctite would be. They used green Loctite too. That's the really odd. Unless the colors mean something different in Japan, which they probably do. That was on there tight. Trying to come down on me. Now it's a lot heavier than I thought. heavy. Okay, I'm just gonna kind of get back and just let it fall. Try not to get hit by it. Probably gonna take two people to put this back on. Here it comes. I gotta unhook. I don't know how to unhook it. Can't get my arm in there. It's the opposite of what I wanted. Okay. Oh, it's never easy. Never easy. Alright, so we need to keep the orientation because this one's a little bit more important. Okay, so now the new problem is getting this undone. Looks like we just loosen. Nope. 12. Sup, Holmes? I'm probably gonna need a hand to put this back on because it's a lot heavier than I expected. Hey, puppy. Ah. Oh, he's a good puppy. Yeah. Don't you eat none of my tools now, okay? What are you sniffing? Ah, I got a puppy. All right, watch out. This is a pain in the ass. And all these bolts that I took out were green Loctited. And I don't know if green Loctite is the same in Japan as it is here, but I have to figure out what kind of Loctite to buy to put back on it. What the fuck? There's probably torque specs too. Pain in the butt. There we go. She's like, fuck you, I want to sit down.
She's been walking all weekend.
Oh, really? Did you go to the parade and everything?
Mm-hmm. Well, that's right, you don't have YouTube or Facebook.
Fuck Facebook.
You would know these things.
Ah, it's a different bolt size. Okay, it's probably the 14. Yes, it is. Holy shit. What the fuck?
You have an impact wrench now. Why don't you use it?
Not everybody has it.
Well, obviously they need it.
Yeah, that's what I'm starting to think. I hope I have Loctite. If not, I'm in trouble. If anything, this should have been done while it was still on the car. That's not what the instructions said. Yeah, I don't know how the fuck am I supposed to do this. Fucking things in there good. The problem with that torque wrench I have is it's too powerful. It would break the bolt head off.
I've done that many times.
I didn't do that once at work, man. I don't know how you did that. Granted, the air pressure was always really low.
Izzy likes to sunbathe. Most black dogs do. It's really weird.
Okay, I have to be careful to have this the right way. was backing up. Okay. Yeah, I definitely feel like that could have been done while it was on the car. You probably wouldn't have been able to get the sway bar out, but could have at least broken the bolt loose. This is a pain in the butt. Keep all this in the right orientation. All right, so we match. Wow, even this one's about twice as big. It's fucking awesome. It's gonna make a huge difference. Hopefully no more spinning out, huh? Alright. Orientation. Okay. So it goes in like that. Oh, dude. Here comes the fun part. Alright, so just like the rear, we're going to use half a tube in each bushing to make sure it doesn't make noise. We're going to actually go back and work on the Mustang one of these days. So that's about half, and the other half in here.
If you run out of lube, I got some.
Okay, now I gotta do this again. Oh, oh man. Oh, dude, this is... You missed doing the back one. The back one, I had to use my pinky. I was telling our viewers that I'm so glad this is not what you know what feels like, or I would be like, ugh. This feels like I'm fingering grilled cheese. You want to feel it?
No, I'm good.
You want to finger my grilled cheese?
How do you know what fingering grilled cheese is like?
That's a good question. Oh, this is disgusting.
Did you have sex with a bowl of macaroni and cheese once?
And its sister. Oh, this is disgusting.
Just remember, put a condom on. That way your dick won't get all cheesy.
Oh, jeez. Oh, oh, that is nasty. Ugh. Okay, so now we got to get them on. What is that?
Can't see.
Motorcycle?
Something.
Sounds like a motorcycle.
And there's a bunch of motorcycles on today.
Yeah, there are. Alright, so now we gotta spread it apart. Oh, crap. How am I supposed to do that? That's gonna suck. Where'd the tiles go? Shit.
big mower. All
right. This is gonna be tough. Fuck. How am I supposed to do that? Shit. Wait, there we go. There we go. Alright. It's on there. So now we gotta kind of work it in, make sure it's all nice and oiled up. Okay. Now, got to change our mounts over. Bad. All right. We can thread our nuts back on.
Adjust my 401k plan. 10% is just too much.
Too much?
Too much.
Well, at least yours is activated. I gotta wait a year.
I think I might bring it down to 6%.
My plan is just to do what the match is and just stay there, you know. Free money.
Make sure I have a boatload of money when I retire. Ah. A boatload. Like a boat full of $100 bills. in a brand new boat. That would be perfect.
He'd spend all that money in gas in one day. True. It's like the only biggest downside to boats is gas. Because if you don't buy the gas away from the lake, you're going to be paying out your butt.
Well, that's when you get a big ass truck to haul all the gas.
You just buy a gas tanker.
Or you just buy a house that has its own dock.
There you go.
A house on the river. Or on the lake. That'd be what you do.
Okay.
Dude, I was hydroplaning at 75 miles an hour. I couldn't even get past 70.
Yeah, dude, that rain was bad. I was staying around 65.
It was pushing me all over the road when I tried to get past 70.
Yeah, those are race tires. Yeah. All right, so we're just gonna snug these.
But today, I shaved 30 minutes off my drive time.
Uh-oh. Shit. Did I just... I guess it's right. We'll find out. Shave 30 minutes off. Nice.
Made the trip in 3 hours.
pretty good.
Yeah. I want a radar detector. Cops on those highways don't have the money or attention span to use a radar, a LiDAR, so they all just radar.
Yeah, but it sucks though, because on 55, that's all they use. Yeah. Ah, this is going to be a pain in the butt. Now we gotta get this tight somehow. I don't know how. Okay. That shouldn't go anywhere.
You know, I'm gonna go over to his house.
Oh, dude, they got two new Honest trailers online now.
Cool.
Yeah. Yeah, I haven't watched them yet. Guess we'll sound today too.
Yeah.
Wonder if it'll be any good. That's tight. Now we can go back and finish this off. This is such BS. I don't know how you're supposed to tighten that.
Very carefully?
I guess. I mean, there's just no way to hold the pieces in place.
I'm gonna put some shorts on.
Shorts? Okay. Oh man, I'm getting tired. All right, for the part where we're gonna put this back in the car, we're gonna need a hand, so Brad's gonna help us. And all right, Brad, let's do the other side first. Got the tools over here already. So you will have to be on this side of the tire and underneath where you'll be able to get a hand on it. So basically, it's kind of got to hook up over the... not far enough in. We gotta hook up over our steering rod, and then I'm gonna put that soft setting. It's not wanting to play along. Shit, did they not? Okay, I was gonna say they might have put too much paint on it.
No, it's just binding.
I don't know what to do. Ooh. That piece of plastic, shit. All right, I gotta take it back out. Crap. Okay, it's gotta go. Oof, that's not good. All right. So it goes up like this.
Mm-hmm.
And then, all right, let's just get it bolted in first. So, the short one goes there, and the long one goes I think it's in a hole. Shit. Oh fuck, what'd I do with that? Okay. Now these two. Can you move that at all? Like, is it gonna wiggle? Any wiggle room? No.
No.
Okay, it's cross-threaded or something.
Mm-hmm. Take it out.
Ow! Fuck, I just... Hold up. Yeah, it's just not lined up.
Push it this way.
This way?
Yeah.
Man, I scratched it all the hell.
Still want to cross through.
Hmm.
There we go. Well. Maybe, nope.
Here, let me. What the hell? Just doesn't want to go back in. Going on with it. Here, let it drop just a little bit, like halfway. The threads could be fucked up on the... There we go. That's it. Just, the threads are just that stiff. Okay. So, snug it. Damn it, don't tell me this one's cross-threaded too. So fucking heavy. Almost there. I'm definitely gonna have to borrow a torque wrench for this. Alright, we'll do the other side real quick. Alright, so other side. Threads just these. Is it lined up?
Yeah.
Doesn't feel like I'm hitting anything.
Did a girl say that to you often?
Oh, push it my way.
Just give me a bolt. It needs to go outside. Yeah, way out.
Yeah, I'll loosen those. Well, the sway bar is probably putting some pressure on it by now, so. There you go. Alright. Alright, that's all I need help with, really. For now. Man, this sway bar fucking... it doesn't even want to move. That's weird. Yeah, well.
Because I was thinking of heading out now.
Alright, man. I'll see you later. Thank you. So now we gotta tighten this down somehow. We gotta get it as tight as we possibly can, because that's how it was when we got it off. We can also push our little pop tab back in. Pull it out the rest of the way first. Pop it back in. There we go. Now, to tighten this somehow. Get those tight. That's a problem. It's a huge problem. I'm gonna put this in the soft setting. If it even wants to go in there. On this time, we'll hope it behaves itself, which it's not, of course. Just sucks I can't work with my right hand. Just got dirt in my eye. Great. How the heck? I need a wrench. I think I couldn't even find a 14. Or did I? Wait, was the 14 wrench seriously the one I couldn't find? I thought I just had a 14. What? Alright, I found it. It's always in the last place you look. Alright. Wait. It's not a 14? Was it a 17? This one I modified. I might not have a 17. Shit. Five eighths work. It will not. Oh no. 1/16. Yes. Alright, so we gotta tighten this down. See, now it's not spinning. It's so weird. The other side. Put this somewhere safe. So I gotta go drive around and loose, see if anything comes loose before I can put that back on. All right. Back where it belongs. Okay, and then try to get this in, even though it's gonna wanna be a problem. I can do that. Man, that sway bar is close to that arm. Wants to be a problem. Okay, I'm gonna take the car off the jacks, go drive it around, and come back and put it back on the jacks. In the meantime, the GoPro will be charging. Alright, so I grabbed an impact, and I'm going to carefully tighten down these problem bolts, if the impact will even fit. Very carefully. Man, the shitty impact. Okay, and check this again. trying to take our RX-7 for a ride. Since it's nice and warm and it runs in warm weather. That is a worthless impact driver, but it's better than nothing. All right. All that's done. All right. Trying to take our RX-7 for a ride. Since it's nice and warm and it runs in warm weather.